studies, I will analyze three country songs from different times of varying styles. I will also explore how the communication of authenticity has changed throughout the history of country music. I will first analyze a folk song called I Ride My Pain to discuss where folk and country music began, and then analyze Tennessee Whiskey by George Jones and Tennessee Whiskey Power by Chris Stapleton to explore how country music technique and the sound of authenticity developed and changed over time. Country music can be traced back to folk songs. Folk music was passed down orally and was not written or recorded until the 20th century. In most countries, folk music was informal and intended for small social gatherings. The songs reflected nationalist ideas about the experiences of the time they were written in. It was described as people's music. Folk music was often written with the idea of nationalism. The songs discussed political and social issues such as war, work, community, religious ideas, and the working class. Bless you. American folk music was developed in the 18th century and comes from the Anglo-Americans and Celtics and eventually combined Native American music and African music to create a unique folk sound in America. Nationalism and folk music became connected when the low class and ordinary person felt that there was no music they could relate to. The music at that time was high class symphonic art that reflected the rich and wealthy lifestyle. Folk music therefore became a style of music for the ordinary person and their customs. They discussed hardships of life that particular people such as the low class experienced. It also expressed cultural and ethical diversity as immigrants in different races and cultures were coming to America. While folk music can rarely be traced back to the original songwriter, it is known that folk music was written and performed by the common folk. These songs were not written down as sheet music, but rather written with just the lyrics at times were never written down at all. John Allen Lomax was credited for writing lyrics and sheet music for most of the folk songs that they heard throughout the nation. They did this to preserve the music, but also what the music stood for, as it was based on nationalism from the Southern white folk. Folk music is described as the authentic voice of a group of people, as it reflects their everyday lives, experiences, and ideas. One example of a folk song is Get Along Little Bogies, written, the original songwriter is unknown, but it is about a family. In the 1920s, folk music was rebranded as hillbilly music. Hillbilly music was a broad genre that covered folk, bluegrass, western music, and gospel music. Hillbilly music was essentially a commercialized form of folk music. It was intended for profit, but still used the same ideas of folk music, including the poor white southern working class. Performers were often told to dress as a stereotypical hillbilly for show. This included a sloppy hat, overalls, rolled up pants, and an unkempt look. Singers often sang in an unnatural thick southern accent as well. Songs during this era started to become more personal. The music described illnesses that artists may have faced or the death of a family member. These personal stories were written as a way for the artist to express an emotion that was true and real for them instead of singing about something they didn't experience or know very little about. Other people were then able to relate to the songs. One example of a hillbilly song was recorded by Fiddle and John Carson and called Little Mary Fagan describes the murder of Mary Fagan. The hillbilly era ended around the 1940s when it was then called country music. It was described as the first American music. Country music is a commercial genre in the early 20th century that reflects life for the rural, white, southern, and working class. Like folk music, it used simple instrumentation and was written and performed by the common folk. These performers were untrained, nasally vocalists that performed songs that described self-reliant people and the children of nature unbothered by urban society's constraints. The songs were described as rustic, natural, and relatable to the listener as they focused on the working class, politics, and nationalism. One example of a country song after World War II is In Your Mind by Johnny Cash, which discusses religion. In the 1950s, the genre experienced popularity and therefore experienced profit. Country music began to add unnatural instrumentation, such as the steel and slide guitars, adding instrumentation not normally found in the genre, such as horns and winds. Country music is still used the acoustic guitar, mandolin, banjo, and fiddle to preserve the countryside of the music. The lyrics changed as a new middle class arose, focusing on war, drugs, civil rights, and poverty and the urban class. The music was no longer basic and simple, and instead focused on music that could bring profit or remain true to the genre and the people. In the 21st century, music began to use technology to create ideas. This was also used in country music and created a feeling of unnatural, expressionless music. At the same time, time, country music reached out to more people who wanted the music to express the hardships of everyday life, not just for one social class. The genre was no longer basic and simple, but was finding a new way to express the conception of authenticity for a new life. Authenticity is a concept in music. A song cannot be labeled authentic or unauthentic based on fact. Rather, authenticity is an idea that is different among people of varying cultures, religions, and experiences. The concept of authenticity is an interpretation of the listener and how well the artist conveys the song or story within the song. Based on the concepts related to authenticity, the concept authentic can be music that is original, familiar to both the artist and the listener, and has been inspired by an event or an idea. Authenticity is important in country music as the music has been developed and heard by the working class American. The music is perceived as honest, rooted, relatable, and natural. The artist was relatable through their southern, untrained voices and informal appearance. Artists used a high, lonesome, nasally voice that was untrained as many could not afford lessons or were self-taught. A high, lonesome voice timbre is heard as a high modal sound that you can find within 2 to 4 part harmony. This technique and sound is still found in country music today, but mainly among male singers. Because authenticity is based on perception and is a concept, authenticity can change. One way the concept of authenticity in country music has changed is in the lyrics. As mentioned before, country music focused on the people of the working class with lyrics that describes the joys and sorrows of life. However, it can be agreed that the working class has changed compared to what it was. The working class in the late 1800s consisted of common people with little to no education, whereas the working class present today consists of common people with some form of education. Country songs have adapted to the change in society to reflect the new authentic life of the people. It describes the hardships of life and refused to make light of the problems the common people faced. The melodies in country songs were simple with a rough beat. Most country songs have melodies within an octave or an 11th in range. The rhythm of country songs would often vary in tempo as the performer usually accompanied themselves and didn't use a metronome, though this has changed. The form of folk and hillbilly songs are verse and chorus. Country songs use the form verse, chorus, and bridge, with the bridge acting as a turning point for the song. The chords usually follow the traditional 1-4-5 chord progression with the occasional minor 6. The harmonies in country songs are close harmonies. They often outline a triad. Typical country harmonies are found in 2-4 parts. They usually stay within the scale of those being played, for example, major, minor, or blues. Country music has also changed its instrumentation. Country music focused on acoustic instrumentation such as strings, bass guitar, and drums. Acoustic instrumentation was seen as natural and simple, and at times it seemed like authenticity had been destroyed when the electric guitar was introduced. However, many argue that adding instruments that are electric created by technology is a new way to express a deeper emotion that natural instruments could not. Authenticity in this case was not lost, but rather expressed in a different way. The choice of instrumentation often expands the expression of emotion in music, and some feel as though the use of technology creates a fake or a natural sound, and therefore has taken away from authenticity. My first example is I Ride in Old Paint, which is a folk ballad first recorded in 1927, though the original creator remains unknown. The lyrics contribute to the conception of authenticity because of their association with cowboys and because of the truthful informational content. The rhythm adds to the conception of authenticity as the meter of the song is in 3-4, imitating the motion of a horse walking. Played at a faster tempo would still match the rhythm of a horse's natural jog or canter. The verses match each other, only changing rhythm when a word or syllable is added. Each phrase begins on the beat, never starting in between beats. The song also follows the tradition of folk and country music by playing the 1, 5, and 4 chords, in this case A, E, and D. The melody is simple, often repeating the same notes and phrases. The notes remain within a major third of the key, not going lower than the fifth of the key. This makes the song easy to sing for an untrained voice. Most versions of the song found today use only guitar, but there are a few recordings that use guitar, bass, fiddle, and banjo. This keeps the song sounding acoustic as electric instruments are not used. The conception of authenticity in the song relies on tradition. The natural instrumentation, easy melody, and harmony follows the folk tradition. And I will play it right away. Tennessee Whiskey is a country song originally written by Dean Dillon and Linda Hargrove, and were first recorded by George Jones in 1983. However, the song became a huge success as the version released by Chris Stapleton in 2015. Though Jones' version is considered authentic, it can be argued that it's considered so because it kept tradition. George Jones keeps true to the country music tradition by adding a simple melody that is phrase heavy, with each phrase beginning on the strong beat, such as beats 1 and 3 as seen in the chorus of the song. The song stays within an octave, relying mostly on the root and the fifth of the key. Tennessee Whiskey follows the traditional chords 1, 4, and 5, and the occasional 2 chord. The instrumentation was guitar, bass, drums, harmonica, and piano. The bass plays the root and the fifth of each chord on the beats 1 and 3 for a traditional country bass line. The conception of authenticity in this song is formed from the performance of George Jones. Jones uses a nasally and high lonesome voice that makes the song country. Jones seems to almost carve the lyrics out as he battles alcoholism and falls in love. Though he does use smooth vocal lines to show that he's sober, he does have a scale going down at the end of each phrase to show that he might still be a little bit drunk. Stapleton does use a nasally voice, however, but uses a full voice as well, and the chorus is to bring it to the top of his range. The melody is more complex as the notes reach a full octave and use riffs like in major 6 of your example in your handout. The words are occasionally slightly offbeat, adding to the authentic drunk feeling as drunks are mostly loud and slow their words. Stapleton aims to show this through vocal inflections at higher pitches. Though the song is a cover, Stapleton did make it his own, and as to the authenticity of the song. Communicate authenticity for different eras in music. Both songs use authentic instrumentations for their genres and times. They use the high lonesome sound for authenticity as well. Though the communication has changed, both communicate authenticity. I have have discussed the concept of authenticity in country music and described folk, hillbilly, and country music, and the concept of authenticity originates from folk music and nationalism. Authenticity and the concept of it in music is the relation to the common people in a political and social way, and is what the artist conveys and the listener feels is authentic. The concept of authenticity has changed due to the changes in society and social classes. I looked at how instrumentation, rhythm, and lyrical ideas have contributed to the perception of authenticity in several different songs, from I Write an Old Pain, Where Authenticity Began, and Tennessee Whiskey by George Jones and Chris Stapleton, to show how the communication of authenticity changed over time.
This goes to the idea of authenticity from the Tennessee Whiskey. I know you said that both have their points about being authentic. Would you say that Chris Stapleton first is also authentic by some armies, and what armies just him and his wife was more like on beat than he is?
It could be, yeah, because she's definitely singing kind of like in a more sober sound, I guess, whereas he still sounds like he's kind of tipsy from having one too many.
Not a question, just a comment. I've never seen the sheet music for that run on Warren.
It was so complicated, man.
I've seen that song a lot. I never tried it ever. I've never seen that many notes on Warren. Word. That's so cool.
Yeah. When he did it, he did mention that he was just kind of going with it.
Just running.
So this run is kind of like a simplified version of his. So in his, he kind of does it different with every performance he
does. Yeah, okay.
Do you know when it became fairly standard to play it in triple meter or compound meter? Because it seems like every solo artist and cover band always does it in simple meter. Can you speak to that?
From what I could tell, when Chris Stapleton sang it is when it became kind of traditional to do the triple meter.
When was that?
In 2015.
2015.
Yeah, it's for at least that song was when it was traditional to kind of sing a triple meter. For that song.
Okay.
He changed the meter, but when he did, he was also singing with Justin Timberlake, and they were doing a mashup song. So he changed the meter to match that song so it would make it easier to jump into the song. But then it just, everybody liked that version better and ended up being a triple meter.
You, forgive me, you might have already covered this. Did the George Jones version have any bit of a triplet feel to it, or was it straight do?
Straightforward.
Really?
The whole time. Straightforward. Never started in between beats. It was always just straightforward. I think there was one section that did, but there was no like triplet feel to it.
So let me throw another follow-up question at you. Is there something about the 12-8 feel or that triplet feel that makes it sound more old-timey, do you think?
I think so, yeah. Especially with the way the guitars were playing, which they were slightly off beat every time, hitting on the end of the beat. So,
oh yeah.
And then the bass playing on the downbeat every time. So I think that created kind of like a waltz feel, but also like before when I mentioned like the horse's walk, it also creates that feel as well.
Good point.
And I guess you can interpret it like, because honestly, I've never thought of that song as being a 12-8. I just thought of it being a 4. And so maybe that has something to do with it, because you think about it like, I don't know, maybe that triplet, people like hear it as triplets, maybe they associate that with that old time piece, like a swinging kind of.
Right, yeah, that probably is it. When I first started writing this, I did try to write it in 4-4, and realized that things weren't fitting, things were really weird to kind of put together. So then I kind of shifted the beat around and eventually found it really simple.
Questions?
There's actually something else that I noticed in the George Jones and in that really old tune from 27. The emphasis of the lead tone. Like you get to a 5 chord, it's like you actually have a melody that's on the leading tone, and then even when you were playing the George Jones version, like the C major chord, you really brought out the E. And I feel like in pop music, I've noticed in pop music there's such a avoidance of the leading tone because it sounds so quote unquote too country.
Right.
And so I wonder if do people hear the Chris Stable intent and be like, oh, well, it's not country enough because it.
I do get it. When I first listened to the song, I did kind of think it was like a pop country song.